Hello friends, this is Dr. Sangeeta from Dental Pathshala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And we are doing myofunctional appliances in the ortho. Till now we have covered vestibular screen, we have covered lip bumper, activator, Frankel's appliance, and today's topic is bionator. Now there are three types of bionator. The first one is the most common used, which is the standard appliance. Now all the pictures you are seeing is the standard type of bionator. Also we'll study open bite bionator, and there is one more reverse type of bionator is there, which is used in class 3 cases. Now the standard appliance is usually used in class 2 division 1 cases, and all the bionator have two components: the wire component, which is seen in the blue, and the acrylic component, which is seen in the red in the diagram. Now also we'll study the construction bite and the wear time. Apart from that, we'll study the history, principles, and the treatment objective of bionator, and advantages and disadvantages of bionator, and where bionator is indicated, where we don't give bionator. So let's get started. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture. Now let me give you a brief about bionator. Actually it is somewhere similar to the conventional activator, but activator was more bulkier, so the bionator given by Bolters is less bulkier and is more elastic, and it focuses on the tongue. It corrects the class 2 division 1 malocclusion, and with a patient having narrow dental arches. So what it does, it corrects the backward position of the tongue. So basically the action of bionator is on the tongue. You have to remember this. So it works on the tongue, it works on the positioning of the tongue, and it is given in the patient with class 2. We are talking about the standard now. So the class 2 division 1 cases having narrow dental arches, because it increases the mass of the tongue and it brings the lip closure. Also it brings the tongue backward. Now there are two components in it. The one is the acrylic component, the other one is the wire component. The acrylic component is actually fitted into the lingual surfaces of the mandibular teeth. Can you see these bar thing? It is actually the lower part, and the upper part is the plain part. So the acrylic part, there are two parts to it. One is the upper and other one is the lower part. The plain area you can see is the upper area, and if you can see indentation of premolars and molars. So the maxillary plate, it covers only the molars and the premolars, and in the maxilla upper region, the anterior part is not covered. Only molars and premolars. And the lower part, if you talk about, it is fitted to the lingual surfaces of the mandibular anterior teeth. So these are the two components of acrylic. The first, the upper maxillary plate and the mandibular plate, and maxillary plate covers only the molars and premolars. Now you can visualize this, that this is the maxillary part. In the maxilla, if you see, this is the maxilla. So if you can visualize, it only covers the premolars and the molars. And in the mandible, it covers the lingual surfaces of the anterior teeth, lingual aspect of the mandibular arch. Also, it has the wire component. Now, there are two wire components, the palatal arch and the vestibular wire. The palatal arch is made up of 1.2 millimeter wire, and the vestibular wire is made up of 0.9 millimeter wire. So if we talk about the acrylic part, actually it covers the upper posterior teeth, right? The premolars and the molars. It prevents the supra eruption of the posterior teeth, and it also acts as the posterior bite plate. Now the wire component we talked about, there are two wire components. One is the palatal and one is the vestibular. And the palatal part is made up of 1.2 millimeter wire, which I've told you, and it emerges opposite to the middle of the first premolar and reaches up to the distal surface of the first permanent molar. So it starts, emerges from the opposite of the premolar, first premolar. If we talk about the vestibular wire, it is made up of 0.9 mm stainless steel wire, and it takes a turn. So it is actually a kind of a labial bow, which takes a turn, which we'll study about in detail. So coming to the history of bionator, now first activator was given by Anderson in 1908, and after that Wilhelm Walther in 1960 gave the bionator, and after that Frankl's appliance by Professor Rolf Frankl in 1967 was discovered. Now this was the history of the bionator. If we talk about the principle of bionator, bionator is actually less bulkier than the activator, I've told you, and it works on the tongue, and which is actually the central reflex activity in the oral cavity, and it enlarges the oral space and actually trains the tongue in the backward position, and it accomplishes the lip seal and bringing the dorsum of the tongue in contact with the soft palate. Now what it is doing is it is taking the tongue backward, and it improves thereby the relationship of the jaw, the relationship of the tongue and relationship of the teeth, and it is bringing the incisor edge to edge relationship, and also it achieves the elongation of the mandible. It works basically or by modulating the muscle activity, by modulating the tongue positioning. So this is what it does, and if we talk about the advantages about the bionator is that it is less bulkier, which is the most important advantage of the bionator, because activator was more bulkier and therefore it can be worn both in the daytime as well as in the night time, and the action is actually faster than the activator because unfavorable forces are avoided acting on the dentition for a long time and constant wear, so more rapid adjustment of musculature is seen. Now, but also it has certain disadvantages, like it is difficult to manage, difficult to stabilize, and the most important is the selective grinding, which is difficult, which we are not covering in the today's part because you are not being a BDA student, you require this much only. So it is more vulnerable to distortion because less support in the alveolar and the incisal regions. Now if we talk about where it is used in class 2 division 1, we have already covered with the narrow dental arches. So the mandible in the posterior position and the labial tipping of incisors where is evident it is used. It is also used in cases with the open bite, which is a type of bionator open bite, and it is also used in class 3 where the reverse bionator can be used. But it is not used in the patient with a vertical growth pattern. Now the patient who are showing vertical growers, who have vertical growth pattern, bionator is not used in those cases. And also where there is the labial tipping of mandibular incisor, there also bionator is not used because it covers the lingual surfaces of the anterior lower anterior teeth. बेसिकली बायोनेटर का क्या काम है कि वो टंग को पीछे पोस्टीरियरली पोजिशन कर रहा है, तो टंग की पोजिशनिंग पे काम करता है और कम भारी है एक्टिवेटर से, इसीलिए ये एक्टिवेटर से बढ़िया है, एक्टिवेटर के बाद आया था, बॉल्टर्स ने दिया था. कमिंग टू द स्टैंडर्ड अप्लायंस और वी कैन से द न्यूट्रल बायोनेटर. Now the standard appliance has two components, the acrylic component and the wire component. The acrylic component lower is a horseshoe shape. Now these, the one with the bar is the lower component. Is the lower component is a horseshoe shape acrylic lingual plate from the distal of the last erupted molar of one side to the distal of the last erupted molar to the other side. Now if we talk about, I can also put a line like this. Okay. Now the lower segment extend from the last erupted molar up to the last erupted molar and the lingual surfaces. So there is the lingual bar which is present, the acrylic bar. If we talk about the upper arch, the lingual extension cover only the molars and the premolars. So only the premolars and the molar in upper area is covered, and in the lower whole of the thing is covered till the last erupted molar. Now if we talk about the wire component, there are two components of the wire. One is the palatal arch, the other one is the vestibular arch. If we talk about the palatal bar or the palatal arch, is made up of 1.2 millimeter wire, and it extends from a line which connects the distal surface of the permanent molars to the middle of the first premolar. Now it is kept 1 millimeter away from the palatal mucosa, so it is not, this wire is actually not touching the palatal mucosa, it is away from the palatal mucosa, it is away from the mucosa, and the basically the palatal bar orients the tongue and the mandible anteriorly by stimulating the dorsal surface of with the palatal bar. Now it is actually orienting the tongue, It is actually stimulating the dorsal surface of the tongue with the palatal bar, and the labial bow is made up of the vestibular wire, which is made up of 0.9 millimeter wire. Now you can see this is the labial bow. Also both the wire component and the bionator are passive. That means they are not touching the mucosal surface. All the wire component in the bionator are actually passive. Nothing is touching the mucosa. So the labial bow is made up of 0.9 millimeter wire and begins above the contact point between the canine of the upper premolars. It runs vertically, and actually the labial portion of the bow should be paper thickness away from the incisors. So it is little bit away from the incisors. Now there are two parts of the labial bow. One is the anterior part, one is the lateral part. Now the anterior part is our labial wire, and the lateral part, if we talk about, is the buccinator bend. Now this bend is the buccinator bend. So there are two components of vestibular wire. One is the labial wire and other one is the buccinator bend. Now this buccinator bend actually keep the soft tissues away from the teeth. So the function of buccinator bend is it keeps the soft tissues away from the cheek, and thereby the bite is leveled and eruption proceeds in the buccal segment. Also it moves the cheek laterally. Basically its function is to move the cheeks away, which favors the expansion or transverse development of the dentition, because this is more or like a coffin spring. So what it is doing is it is expanding the arch, and this buccinator bend is actually keeping the soft tissues away. ये क्या कर रहा है? Basically soft tissues को cheeks को बाहर push कर रहा है. तो ये क्या कर रहा है? Soft tissues, it is keeping the soft tissues away. Now coming to the open bite kind of bionator, we have already covered the standard appliance. Now the open type bionator is actually used to close the anterior space. It is used in the open bite to close the anterior open bite, and the acrylic part of this open bite is actually the lower lingual part extends into the upper incisor region as a lingual sheet, and it closes the anterior space without touching the upper teeth. The bow of the open bite, it runs between the upper and the lower incisors at the height of the lip closure. Now, and it closes the space. And if we talk about the reverse or class 3 kind of bionator, it is actually opposite of the standard bionator. You can see the labial bow was in upper. Now in this reverse, the labial bow is in the lower thing, and it encourages the development of the maxilla, and bite opens up to 2 millimeters for this purpose, and the acrylic portion extends incisally from canine to canine behind the upper incisors, and acrylic is trimmed 1 mm behind the lower incisors. And the palatal bar of the reverse kind is reverse. Now the palatal bar, the standard appliance palatal bar is like this. If these are the premolars and these are the last mesial surface of the first permanent molar, then the palatal bar is actually different. Palatal bar is like this for class 3 or for the reverse kind of bionator. It runs forward with a loop extending as far as the first deciduous molar or the permanent molar. Now the function of palatal bar of the reverse in the reverse or class 3 bionator is that it contact the tongue to anterior portion of the palate and encourage the forward growth to this area. And the standard bionator, in which the labial was in the upper incisor region, so the labial bow of the reverse or class 3 is present in the lower incisor region and wire slightly touches the labial surface. If you remember, it was a paper thick away from the which was in the standard appliance, but it slightly touches, or it is also like at the paper thickness away. Now coming to the construction bite. When we are making a construction bite for a bionator, actually it is to achieve a class 1 molar relationship. In case of edge to edge relations of incisor, it is provided to maximum functional space for the tongue. And if overjet present is too large, then step by step procedure is followed. And in case of the open bite, the construction bite is actually kept as low as possible with a slight opening at the interposition of the posterior bite block to prevent their eruption. And if we talk about the reverse or class 3, the construction bite is taken more in the retruded position. The mandible should be retruded so as to allow the labial movement of the maxillary incisor and also to exert the restrictive forces on the lower arches. and the appliance must be worn day and night except while eating. The patient is actually recalled after 1 week to check if any sore spots are developed due to acrylic, then they should be removed. And the interval between the visit 3 to 5 weeks based on the eruption of the teeth, and it takes 1 to 1.5 years to achieve the result of the bionator correction, and the labial bow is kept away from the incisor. It is not putting any force on the incisors, and the buccinator loops are away from the first and second molar, should not irritate the mucosa also. And bionator can be used for treating TMJ problems in adult also, and it prevents the riding of the condyle over the posterior edge of the disc, which causes the clicking. The bionator positions the mandible forward, so prevent the deterioration effect at the night. And also bionator, if we use it along with a local heat application with the muscle relaxants, it provide immediate relief for the patients. So this is all about the bionator, and bionator is effective in treating the functional or the mild skeletal class 2 division 1 malocclusion in the mixed and in the transitional deciduous dentition, and provided that the appliance is chosen after careful diagnostic study and it is made correctly and managed properly by loading and unloading the different areas as indicated in the patient. And the patient should wear it in both in the daytime as well as in the night time. So this is about bionator. And if you find difficulty in understanding the bionator, then I'll recommend you to Google the picture of bionator. This is just the acrylic part, and the lower, if we talk about standard appliance, the lower it covers the whole thing and upper only premolars and molars. There are both the wire component is actually kept away from the tissues. If you can see, the wire is kept away, and this is the buccinator loop, this is the vestibular wire and the palatal arch of the bionator. So this is all about bionator, and leave it in the comment below the next topic you want to read. And if you feel that you have learned something new today, then go ahead and hit the comment box and the like button, because this helped me to help you skyrocket your career and help you with the exams and knowledge while you stay at home in the lockdown with your family.